Hello, my name is Bruno Oliveira, and I'm an engineer in the Play Games team. And in today's DevBytes episode, we're going to talk about a problem that comes up very often in multiplayer games. And that is, of course, how do you choose who goes first? Remember that multiplayer is symmetrical, so no one is naturally special. There's no server or anything like that. But sometimes you need to choose one of the players to have a special role, like to be the judge of a match, to make the first move, or you need to decide who's player one, who's player two, and so on. So how do you do this? Your first thought looking at the API may be, oh, let me use the room's creator. So the player who's the creator of the room is going to be the judge or is going to make the first move, etc. That's generally a bad idea. And that's a bad idea because there's a funny thing that happens in automatch, because automatch really means that we get a whole bunch of rooms and put them together into a single room. So when you have automatch players in the room, there will not necessarily be agreement on who was the room's creator. So that doesn't work as expected. So you may think, okay, I'm going to use the player ID, right? So everyone has a player ID, I'm just going to sort the player IDs, and whoever has the lowest player ID is going to be the first to play. Again, that's a bad idea, because when you have automatch players, you don't have access to the player IDs of those automatch players, so that method doesn't work either. Okay, what if you just use participant IDs? That's a slightly better idea, because everyone has a participant ID, however, that's still not very good. And why? Okay, let's suppose you're doing something like this. So you get everyone's participant IDs, which are these funny strings. You sort that list, and then you pick that first player on that list to start the game, or to be the king, or to have that special role. Sure, that works, and definitely everyone's going to agree on who has that special role. But here's the problem. So a participant ID is not really a random string. It actually has some structure to it. It's encoded information. So suppose that I'm that last guy over there, and I'm unlucky enough that in every single match that I play, my participant ID begins with a Z. So if I'm unlucky enough that happens, then no matter how many matches I play, I'll never get to play first, I'll never get to be the king, I'll never get that special role in the game. So the game might be very, very boring for me. So we definitely don't want that to happen. So one of the ways you can solve that problem is you sort the list of participant IDs as before. Then you pick the first player on that list, but that player is not going to play the special role. His only responsibility is going to be to randomly choose who's going to be the king or to play first. After choosing that using some sort of like fair method, all you have to do is then broadcast to the other players that selection. And then everyone's going to agree that that player is going to be the king or the leader, and the choice was fair. So no one had the privilege of being the king many times. So and then everyone agrees, and now all we have to hope is that F029 is going to be a wise ruler that's going to lead your game into an age of peace and prosperity. That was it for today's DevBytes. Thank you.